Hi and welcome. In this video, we are going to discuss about how to take a database backup to Azure Cloud. So generally, what we'll do while taking any database backup, what we'll do, we just right click on the database and then go to tasks and then backup. And in the destination, you have two options. One is disk and the other one is URL. So we are going to discuss about this part, URL. So what credentials you need to give when you select URL as a destination? It will ask you a few things. We'll discuss that. Okay. So in general cases, we take the backup to our local disk using the commands backup database to your local disk. So once we execute this T-SQL code, backup file will be stored in your local drive. So in the same way, we are going to take up this backup file directly to the Azure Cloud Storage. So we have Azure Storage account. Azure Storage is a Microsoft managed cloud service which is used to store unstructured data. Like you can store your images, audios, video, logs, or any kind of unstructured data you can store in this Azure Storage account. This is highly available, secure, durable, and scalable and redundant. So this Azure Storage account contains four types of data objects. One is blob storage, file shares, queues, table, and disk. Disk is used for Azure VM, and the data you store in this Azure account is accessed over the HTTP or HTTPS protocols. As I said, this provides the following data services: Azure Blobs, Files, Queues, Tables, and Disks. So we are going to use Azure Blob Storage to store your backup files. So for blobs, we have a container. So what is a container? It is a set of blobs similar to a directory in a file system. It can include unlimited number of containers, and a container can store an unlimited number of blobs. So here you may come across different terminologies, but no need to worry. This is just like a folder in your operating system. So if this is your cloud storage, the rectangle you see here is a storage account. And inside your storage account, you will have a container. And inside this container, you will create folders like this. And inside these folders, you are going to store your images, audio files, or your .bak files, which is your backup file. Let me take you to the Azure portal, so that you will get a clear picture. So here, this is my Azure home screen. Once you log into Azure portal, this will be your Azure home screen, where you will find the Azure services here, or you can search for your required service in the search box. So here I am going to select Azure Storage account. Okay. So if you don't find your Azure Storage account here in the Azure services, you can select from the menu box here, or you can search from the search box. So once I select storage accounts, I'll be taken into the storage account. So here I have already created one storage account with name storage BK101. If you have not created any storage account, it will show you that there are no storage accounts or empty. You can click on the add symbol here and you can create your storage account. Since I have already created my storage account, I am just selecting the storage account. Once I open the storage account, I'll be inside my storage account, and here you can see I have total four data objects. One is container, file share, tables, and queues. So we are going to take our backup files in this container. So here we can store any unstructured data. And I have already made videos on these file shares. I'll leave a link in the description. You can watch it from there. So let me click on this container. And you see, I'm inside the container. So here you can create a new container or any folders here. So container is nothing but a just folder. So if you have not created any container previously, it will show empty. You can create one container by clicking on the plus symbol. And since I've already created a container, I'm just going inside the container. Once I click container, which is named container BK. So here I have my individual files. You can see there is already a backup file placed in my container. If for the database test. So how did I take this backup file to my container? This is what we are going to discuss now. Let me switch to SSMS. Here, the first thing you need to do is you need to create a credential and then perform the database backup to your storage account. And the syntax here is create credential, credential name. So I have given my credential name as test with identity is equal to storage BK101. That is my storage account name. If you remember, I have already created a storage account. Let me show you. So here is my storage account with name storage BK101. Okay. And this is the name I have given here. And comma secret is equal to. So this is the access key of your storage account. So how do you get your access key for your storage account? I'll show you. Once you open your storage account, you will have your containers, file share, tables and queues. So here in the options, you have access keys. So click on access keys. And here you can find two access keys. You can select any one. Once you refresh, it will generate another access key. So here I'm choosing the first key. Let me copy. It is copied. So here I have pasted this access key. So now execute the script. Command completed successfully. So we have successfully created a credential for your storage account. And you can find this credential under security. And you see here credentials. This is our credential which we have created just now. You can double click on it and you will get the properties of your credential. And you can see your credential name, identity, password. You can also create your credential using graphical user interface. You just go here, right click on it. You will get new credential and give the credential name here. And identity is your storage account name and password is your access key of your storage account. Okay. Now our credential is created successfully. So we are going to take a backup to your storage account directly. So I'm going to take a backup of one of my database. Database name is sample202. So backup database name to URL is equal to. So this path is my container path. I'll show you how to get this path from your Azure storage account. Once you open your Azure portal, select storage account and then open your storage account. You will have containers here. Once you open your container, in the properties, you have access policy. Sorry, properties. Once you select properties, you will have your container URL path. Copy this path and go to your SSMS and paste the path here. And then give the database backup file name with extension .bak and then with credential equal to test. So this credential test contain the storage account information. So once I execute this script, your database backup will be performed and backup file will be placed in your storage account, that is inside the container. Let me execute. So it is executed successfully. Now let us go and check inside the container of your storage account. Storage account. Select your container. And inside your container, you have created another folder. So my folder name is container BK. And you see your backup file is placed in your container. So in this way, we perform a database backup and store the backup file in the Azure storage account. You can also do the same thing using graphical user interface instead of using T-SQL scripts. So to create a credential, you can first go to your security tab and then credentials, right click new credential. You can give the credential name here, storage account name, and the access keys of your storage account. And you can click OK. The credential gets created. And then to take a backup of your database, right click on any of the database, go to task, backup, and here at the destination you are going to select URL, and it will ask you to enter the file name. Give the file name with .bak extension and select the SQL credential which we have already created. If you have not created, you can create it from the previous step, or you can also create from here. And here you need to give the Azure Storage container name. So here inside the container you can create inside the storage account you can create many containers. So you can give any container name here. So here in my case I have given container BK. And once you click on OK, backup will be performed and it is stored in your Azure storage container. I hope you have understood the concept. And I hope this video helps. If you like the video, please hit the like button. Do share and subscribe to my channel for more videos. Thank you. Thanks for watching.